Our days are getting shorter right now, so why not look to the night sky for a little entertainment?
Sure, meteorologist Angela Huddy has more on this show that will draw your eyes skyward in a story all new at 6.
A new comet, bright planets, and now a meteor shower. There's a lot for amateur astronomers to look up and forward to.
It is an exciting time to be looking up to the sky, and especially with everything else that's going on. You know, we all would need a reason to look up and smile.
The Perseid Meteor Shower is underway, and the peak is the night of August 11th. Considered the best meteor shower of the year, NASA says you can see up to 50 meteors per hour, and sometimes even more. The fast and bright shooting stars often leave long wakes of light behind them as they streak through the atmosphere.
The moon's going to be in its waxing crescent phase, which basically means it's a little dimmer. It rises later in the evening, and we always want a darker sky to be able to see more meteors and shooting stars overhead.
The Perseids get their name from the constellation Perseus because they appear to radiate from that spot in the sky. But the source of the meteors is debris from the comet Swift-Tuttle.
Comets are those cosmic litterers of the solar system. They leave behind little bits of dust and rock and debris. That as the Earth goes through that same place in space, those little particles get superheated in the atmosphere and can create those brilliant streaks of light we see overhead.
Now here in the Northern Hemisphere, the Perseids are best viewed during the pre-dawn hours, though it is possible to see some as early as 10 p.m.
If you can lay back, give yourself a flat, clear view of the sky, and of course, get away from any lights if you can. The moon's our natural enemy, but any lights from buildings and your porch or your property, those always can spoil the show.
After sunset, you can still just make out Comet Neowise in the southwestern sky, but it is fading quickly. However, Jupiter and Saturn are still bright in the southeastern sky. Now in the morning, it's Mars and Venus still putting on a show before sunrise. I'm meteorologist Angela Huddy reporting.